Money trees have been tempting us in the Animal Crossing series since the very first installment. These wonderful games let us live out our lifelong wish of planting some money and tripling our profits in just a few days' time. Animal Crossing makes it reality. Or, well, game reality, so not reality at all. Throughout history, money trees have been considered good luck charms or signs of financial success. One story speaks of a man placing money in a tree to trick villagers into chopping the tree down, but it backfired and the villager saw the tree as sacred and left it standing. Another story speaks of riding a winged ram to the bronze tree of paradise atop a ceramic mountain, so the stories vary a bit. In Animal Crossing, they are a pretty awesome way to make a bit of money every day. But are you maximizing their incredible potential? The game doesn't give any instructions on, well, basically anything, but especially on how to get the most out of these shining golden spots that appear on your island every day. If you've played past games, you'll probably automatically know what to do with this mysterious glow. But for many, New Horizons is their first Animal Crossing experience, and the developers have yet again changed up the specifics of this returning mechanic. Your reward for finding and digging up the gold spot is 1,000 bells. Don't be so quick to cover up that luminous hole you just made. Grabbing some of your bells and burying them will result in a tree. This tree takes 4 days to grow and produces bells upon reaching the end of its growth cycle. The amount you receive from the tree depends on how many bells you buried. As usual, the percentage chances I'm going to reference were data mined by the one and only Ninji, and weeks of simple testing proved to me that the data that was found is pretty correct. Now to break it down. Burying between 100 and 1,000 bells will grant you 3 bags of 1,000 bells every time. If you're going to bury a small amount, don't plant more than 100 bells, since there is no difference in the result whether you plant 100 or 1,000 bells. Planting between 2,000 and 9,000 bells is a bit more complicated. 30% of the time, you will get 3 times whatever you planted. For example, if you planted 2,000 bells, the reward has a 30% chance of producing 3 bags of 2,000 bells, totaling 6,000 bells. Or, if you plant 9,000 bells, the reward has a 30% chance of producing 3 bags of 9,000 bells each, totaling 27,000 bells. But 70% of the time, you will only receive 3 bags of 1,000 bells, or 3,000 bells total. The chances of this being profitable is incredibly low. You may think that the 30% chance is a good gamble to take. Nope. They thought of a good way to lay out the results over on the Animal Crossing wiki by calculating an entire year's worth of profits when planting bells. So if you plant 2,000 bells every day for 1 year, then you will have planted a total of 730,000 bells. 30% of the time you'll get your 6,000 bells, so that's about 109 days of the year. You'll be blessed with 3 times your money. The other 256 days of the year, you'll essentially lose money and only receive 3,000 bells each day. Well, losing money is probably a bad way to put it. You'll lose the potential for receiving the most amount of money possible. Don't run down in the comments quite yet to show me your math skills. I'm getting to my point. After 365 days at a 30% chance of receiving 6,000, or 3 times the 2,000 that you planted, you'd end up with 910,000 bells of revenue. Subtracting your cost, which is the 730,000 bells I mentioned previously, but also adding in the 365,000 from digging up 1,000 bells every day, your profit will be 545,000 bells. Sounds pretty good, right? Ha! No! Let's go do the same math with planting 100 bells every day for 365 days. This time we get a 100% chance of receiving 3,000 bells every single day we harvest a tree. We end up with a totaling profit of 1,423,500 bells. Almost triple the number of bells you'd make from planting 2k every day. Moral of the story here, if you don't have enough to plant the higher tier of bells I'm about to go over, just stick with planting 100 bells every day. You'll make more in the end. The next option is planting 10,000 bells to 99,000 bells. Similar to the 2,000 to 9,000 group, you have a 30% chance of tripling your money and a 70% chance of getting 3 bags of the lowest value. In this case, 10,000 bells or 30,000 bells in total. All this math. If only math textbooks used Animal Crossing references, maybe we would care about how many watermelons someone bought if Raymond was doing the buying. The total cost for burying 10,000 bells for 365 days is 3,650,000 bells. Subtracting that from the revenue of the 30,000 bells for 365 days, and adding the 365,000 for the 1k bells every day gets us to the final figure of 7,665,000. Now, let's do the math for the 99,000 bells with the 7 70-30% chances. The total cost of planting 99,000 bells every day for a year is 36,135,000 bells. To find our revenue, we take 109 days of 297,000 to get us 32,373,000 and 256 days of 30,000 for 7,680,000. Adding these up gets us 40,053,000. Subtracting our cost and adding in the 365,000, we get a total profit of 4,283,000. We see again that planting the lower amount, in this case the 10K bells every day, is actually the most profitable of the two. Many people think that planting 30,000 bells is the safest bet, which logically would make sense. There's a 70% chance you'll break even and a 30% chance of tripling your profits and getting 90,000 bells. Back to that magical math, your total profit when planting 30,000 bells every day for 1 year with the previously mentioned 70-30% chances will be 6,905,000. That's still 760,000 bells short of the profit you would make when planting 10K every day. If your only concern is the percentage of profit you'll make, your go-to strategy will be planting 100 bells every day. But this isn't your business strategy class, this is how can I make the most bells every day class. And for that, stick with planting 10,000 bells every single time. When testing whether or not the 30% chance theory was correct, I recruited a friend. We both had a couple of weeks where 4 out of the 7 days we actually received 3 times the amount planted, but the other weeks we only profited on 2 days. Time traveling doesn't seem to affect many trees from my experience, so all of you Doc Browns out there are safe to travel as much as you wish. Instead of testing your luck by planting extra bells, maybe stick to the stock market. Or pick that fruit you've been ignoring for a couple of days. Have any questions about money trees? How many bells have you lost trying to triple your money with money trees? Let me know in the comments below. Otherwise, I'll see you on the next video. Bye! Birds.